There's the aftermath of the 96 Mercury Demolition Derby Round 2 on this car. And boy, was that a wild ride in this car. It's been a long time since I've been actually in a full size. As I talked to my past videos, it's been about 10 years since I built a full size to drive. It's been probably 7 or 8 since I actually drove in a full size Demolition Derby, drove a full size car out there. So it was definitely something to get used to again. Compared to front wheel drive, you have to know your throttle response, you have to know how much to push down on the pedal so you don't spin out before gassing it harder, your braking distance, turning radius, all kinds of things that are different than a front wheel drive. So going out there with this car, guys, we went to the Owen County Fall Derby. Remember, Susan ran this car at the Owen County Spring Derby, so we knew there was going to be a target on this car because she placed with it top three. And this is the same paint job, same thing, just different number, different driver. People are going to remember that car in that area. They're going to gun for it. And that was definitely the case. I had a couple targets on me early on. Luckily, either I took them out or they got taken out by other cars, so that helped. Also, there was a lot more cars this time around. 23 total cars in the full-size stock class. And that is both full-frame cars, back-wheel drive, and front-wheel drive cars, because this derby sorts all of their cars by wheelbase length. So you have mini class, very short wheelbase, mid-size, medium wheelbase, and full-size is not sorted by the frame, but full-size for them is sorted by long wheelbase. That's why in the video you will see a lot of front-wheel drive cars out there in the derby, and it was very interesting having a full-frame car going against those front-wheel drive vehicles. Really fun to hit them things with a full-frame car because they just shove right in, and the front-wheel drive cars do not have the weight to them that these cars do, so when you hit them, you can literally push them almost anywhere you want, and they have no control over what happens to them. Definitely not something I would want to do, would not want to run a front-wheel drive car in a stock class against big cars like this. Pretty clear advantage when you have a full-frame car out there. As long as you can keep it running and keep the tires on it, it will dominate those front-wheel drive cars, as you guys saw in the video. Pretty crazy. So going out there, let's talk about the damage on this car, what's going on with it. If you haven't had a chance yet, please go watch the GoPro video, watch the stands footage, but definitely watch the GoPro video because you kind of get a better feel of the damage this car took from certain hits, the directions I drove, and also at the very end of the GoPro, you will see that the steering broke on this car, not in the arena, driving it through the pits back to my trailer, it broke. So let's show you this right away. Gonna have to get this fixed to get the car off the trailer. There is the steering linkage hanging down there. There is where it ties in, right there on the tie rod. It broke off. The threads are still fine. It actually broke right where the clamp goes around the hollow tube. And it's a pretty clean break. I'm wondering if that thing was cracked or fractured from some time long into the derby and it held on that long until finally letting loose, because when you're in the mud, you don't need as much force to turn your wheel because it slides in the mud. Once I was on hard ground, you have to crank harder on the steering wheel to get it to turn, and it may have actually snapped the rest of the way off in the pits because of that reason. So that is how close this car came to not winning the Demolition Derby, guys. Very, very close. Literally one good shot to this tire would have done that rod the rest of the way in, and I would have been driving in circles probably for a good while on that derby, not being able to do much. So pretty crazy to see how that happened. Let's walk around the car now. I got to give you guys an overall of this car to understand what is truly happening. A lot of people may think this car is in really good shape and it could easily run another derby. And yeah, most likely it probably is going to run another derby. Whether it'll be this year or next year, I don't know yet. Needs some work for sure, but as far as placing in another derby, that is probably done for this car. If it runs again, it's probably not going to last long. And this driver's side of this car is the best way to show what is really going on. If you look at the car here, notice how this car is sitting at a pretty big angle and that wheel is collapsed up inside the fender there. That's not because this tire is so big. Yes, that is a big tire, don't get me wrong, it raises the back up a little bit. But what is actually going on this car took a lot of hard front shots head on to a lot of front-wheel drive cars straight into the back of many front-wheel drive cars. I did not try to do too many head-on shots with full-frame cars because a head-on nose-to-nose shot with a full frame never wins for anybody. Usually, your car is going to bend, theirs car is going to bend. Not the good thing you want to do unless it's the end of a derby. Doing that early on and you're going to take yourself out. So, something that happened on this on the frame is something I normally do not see a stock class 90s Ford do. Normally, these 90s Fords, they're going to bend either right here in front of the A-arms, or they're going to bend right there by the crush box, the corners there, and they're going to slowly nose themselves up in the air and stick really high up. That's a common thing you'll see on them when they're nosing up. This one here did something different. It actually shoved straight in on this car. It's shoved in good on this car. I'm going to say a good inch or two is how much it is pushed back on this frame, on these crush boxes. I've crawled under there and looked, and you can see where the crush boxes themselves have collapsed and crushed inwards. The frame rail on the passenger side is actually gone in and up, whereas the driver's side frame rail has barely moved up at all. It's just gone straight in. And the reason I say this isn't something you see on stock cars is because this is a common thing you'll see on mod cars or things that have been built or things that have been tilted, because if you tilt the frame and you pull it down some, usually that leverage of pulling it down stops the frame from going up, and a lot of times tilted cars will shove straight in. But this thing is 100% bone stock frame, bone stock suspension, engine, aluminum rims, everything on it, and it just surprises me to see it push in like that. The only reason I can think that this thing pushed in is because I went against a lot of front-wheel drive cars. And that is something different to hit with a full frame compared to a full frame shot. When you hit another full frame car, your bumpers are pretty even, and when they hit, both vehicles bend upwards at the same time. When you go head on with a front-wheel drive car, especially ones that have stock bumpers like this class did, those compacts crush inwards. So therefore, the force of my hit is also pushing my frame inwards, and there's not that leverage to push up on my frame. And I really do think that doing multiple hard shots on the front end of front wheel drive cars is what does that. It pushes the frame in on this car. I don't know. Leave a comment, guys, if you've ever ran a stock class car and had the frame push in versus up. Very interesting. But that is causing all kinds of problems on the front of this car that I did not know was going on during the derby. So let's look at the front here on this bumper. This is the big issue we have to address if we're going to run this car again. This front cross member on the frame has completely broken all the factory welds there, and underneath has ripped off, and it's done it so bad that bumper shock is loose in here. It's actually been kicking the bumper upwards and back down during the hits. It split the frame rail open right here where the welds are. And over here, it's done it even worse. You can see inside the front of the frame there, it's buckled that up. It's ripped this whole cross member piece off up front. Split the factory welds right there on this thing. The bumper shock is still in. It's still bolted on where I bolted it. It's holding itself. We are allowed to chain the bumper in place to hold it on the car. Luckily, I wrapped it in chains to help hold it. It bought it some time. The only thing truly holding this bumper on was actually the 9-wire run through the hood right up here. I cut that, and once I cut the 9-wire on both sides the day after the derby, this whole bumper actually dropped down by about an inch, and now it's laying in here loose, and if I hit it with a hammer, the entire bumper will shake around. Very lucky that nobody ripped that bumper off with the shots we were taking on the front of that thing. Now, in the very beginning of the derby video, spoiler, if you haven't seen it, please go look at it. I get hit really hard by this front corner by an 80s Ford, 80s Lincoln. His back end comes flying in here, smoked the corner of this bumper, luckily missed most of the fender, almost all bumper damage. When he did that, it V'd his rear bumper in, and that may have cracked this side loose, all those welds from that big shot. Because of that, it may have put pressure on the other side to break off. Honestly, not too sure. But really weird to see how that happened, and I'm not exactly sure how we're going to fix that with most stock class rules around here. I'm gonna have to get a hold of some promoters and see if they will be nice enough to let me re-weld that crossmember piece back on in the exact spot it came off, factory spot only, top and bottom welds. See if they're gonna be okay with that, because without that piece on there, it's really hard to get a bumper shock to stay on when you can't weld the bumper shock to the car. Remember guys, this is a no weld class. These doors are all nine wired. The bumper is factory bolted on with the bumper here. Not sure how else we're gonna get that thing to stay on. So I'll check into that, see what places are gonna work with me for that and still have a fairly bone stock class. I'm not going to put this thing in mods, that'd be suicidal. So getting past that, the actual tires, the aluminum front rims doing great. Rear tires are perfectly fine. No suspension damage whatsoever besides that one steering issue that broke after the Derby. Other than that, I really don't think we took any tire shots. None of the ARMs have been laid over. All of the aluminum trailing arms that hold up the rear end in this, completely fine, no problem there. But let's look under the hood, and I should say under the hood, literally, and see the damage. Let's go underneath first. Look under here. That is gone all the way back, even with the frame. Radiator is for sure damaged. It had water still pouring out of it after the Derby. So that tells me right there that this radiator did not actually rip open until probably the very last couple hits I made at the end of the Derby, when it was down to me and the second place car, which was a Chrysler New Yorker, just like the ugly duckling I used to have and just like the New Yorker that I ran in a Derby. I know those cars plow in the front. That's exactly why I took it head on at the end, because I knew I had the bumper height on it. I knew it was starting to plow in the front. I also knew it was a front wheel drive car and it was going to be like a marshmallow to a full frame. So at that point my car was getting hot. I could hear it starting to get hot with the sound of the engine. So I put her down, took that thing head on, and that was probably the fastest way to end that Derby instead of playing cat and mouse, going back and forth, trying to take wheel shots on each other. So, like I said, as soon as I climbed out of the car, it actually still had water pouring out of the radiator, so I think it just blew the radiator right at that moment. I'm gonna open the hood for you guys, and this is another thing I'm gonna show you, just to get the idea of how bad this frame has pushed backwards. This hood, before I ran the car, I could open this hood all the way up and throw it backwards onto the windshield, and it would stay up on the car. But now, because the entire front frame has pushed backwards underneath the firewall, the hood goes to about right here, and in the corners, it is now hitting the dashboard, hitting the window pillar there on both corners, and this hood is almost vertical. It cannot lean backwards. Normally, it would fall straight backwards and stay up on its own, and that is because everything else is pushed backwards on this car. You can see it starting to push right there on the fenders, but it's way more noticeable right here on the fenders. It's actually crushed the fenders back right there, releasing some of the welds down there. That's buckled and shoved in. It's peeling back right here and underneath there where it is shoved back. The engine itself starting to fall back, but luckily has not broken any of the engine components. The fan itself may have survived the Derby. It is locked up where some of the fins of the radiator have caught the fan, but the fan itself seems still intact. The belt survived the Derby up front, and I also believe the hose is still in one piece for this thing. Luckily, this is an old school copper slash brass style radiator, so it may still be fixable. I think the sidewalls are not damaged at all. It's only fin damage. I may be able to pull it back off, pinch some of the fins that are leaking, and reuse this radiator for one last run on this full-size car. But I don't know, it's hurt pretty good. So this side's been pushed in. It's actually hitting the A-arms off the heater box down there. That was not even touching before. It's now crushed in pretty darn good. Let's take you around to the other side over here and show you this thing. And I gotta drop the hood since it won't stay up. Now over here is where there's an issue that I was not aware of that was happening during the Derby. So this front tire has shoved backwards so far, it is catching inside of that fender and affecting the steering. Not enough to not turn the wheel, but when you turn the steering wheel, you can feel the tire scraping and getting caught. Now here on the frame, if I can give you a good enough angle way back in here, which you really can't see it, down in there is the steering linkage. And that steering linkage is actually rubbing on the bolt right there on the strut and the, or the bolt mount for the A-arms. And one of my fans actually told me during the Derby, he said, hey, you need to trim, before the Derby, you need to trim those brackets back. And I did trim that one back a pretty good amount. I'm talking like half inch to an inch off of that bracket back there, so my steering would not scrape it when this frame bent. But because it pushed backwards, it is rubbing on the steering knuckle. Luckily, not enough to bind it up. That's gonna be an issue we have to address to run this thing further. Walking around to the back of the car, this thing has bent this side not so much. It's actually bent right there where the notch already was, and mostly just body damage, a little bit of frame bending going on. Not as bad as you'd think, mostly just a little in there. If you go around to the other side, this is where it's going funky, and this is because of some of the diagonal shots I took, and also a massive shot this car received from an 80s Buick Cadillac style car. That thing was a well-built car, took third place. It was painted yellow. That thing came screaming in here towards the end of the Derby, smoked this corner. You could see the yellow paint actually from the hit right there. Laid over that frame rail, shifted this whole rear frame that direction, popped the car in the air, threw it back down. It was a big hit. My helmet actually smacked off the pillar of the windshield up there from that hit. That was a good shot. Now that yellow car actually took third place because he was on a rim, which you'll see in the Derby, on one back tire, and the other tire was starting to rub and collapsed in. He drove around the arena and got stuck in a rut, and when he got stuck in that rut, it bottomed out his car, and with only having one tire in the back, he could not get out of it. Other than that, the car was still running and driving. Had he not been stuck, it would have been a way different Derby if me and him would have had to fight it out at the end, because those 80s GM style cars are very tough in the front for stock class Derbies. Other than that, the hump's perfectly fine. Like I mentioned, the rear has not moved. Humps have not moved. They're still perfectly straight back in there. No issues there, no rim damage, nothing at all hitting these things. It's mostly front end that we need to deal with on this car, and that's where I'm gonna have to figure out with some rules what we can and can't do with it to get this thing straightened out. I will mention in the Derby, there is one thing you guys will notice in my GoPro video, and this is something I stand by that I do not like. Do not do holding in a demolition Derby if it is not a team Derby. You will notice in the video there were a couple different cars that obviously knew I was a threat, knew who I was, or something of the matter, and they would come and hit me and hold the front of my car in place against the wall, against another car, and sit there and wait for someone else to take a shot on me, maybe one of their buddies to come take a shot on it. I don't know the case, but they were holding me for a long period of time, and when cars do that, I will get mad, and I will make sure that car is eliminated before I continue with the rest of the Derby, because that is just a cheap shot. It's a cheap tactic. Do not do holding if it's not a team Derby. So you'll see in the video what I'm talking about. I'm not trying to call out names or drivers or cars in the video, but you won't know what I mean when that kind of stuff happens. I'm okay if you're going to tag team, if you're going to, you know, full track stuff, just don't do holding. So because of that, there was some interesting outcomes at that Derby with this car and using it for a couple shots. Other than that, I had a blast. It was really fun running a full size car again. Am I going to get permanently back into full size? No, definitely not. I'm still staying with my front wheel drives. I have more control of them. I like them. I understand them better. And it's much, much cheaper to build a front wheel drive car than it is on this car. These are very expensive to build, even for a stock class, just for the parts. A 80s style Ford bumper like that in Indiana, the average price for them is $125 to $150 for one bumper. Pretty darn pricey just for that, let alone good solid core radiators, axles, steering components, all that stuff that adds up. It's just not worth it anymore if you're not competing for big money. I don't really like to build cars for big money. Always a cheap budget builder. So stay tuned, guys. We'll let you know what comes of this car. Thanks again to our two awesome sponsors that have been with us all season long, Clayton's Auto Parts. They have been helping us out getting all of these tire flaps, all these tires mounted. Without them, none of this would have been possible on these massive mud tires. And our other sponsor right there, you can kind of see it buried in the mud, Outlaw Graphics, hooking us up with amazing decals all season long, brand new roof signs, and our awesome team shirts. If you haven't seen them, check us out in person in the pits. Check out our team shirts. Really cool. Thanks to them, Outlaw Graphics. So this is Demolition Missions, guys. I'm going to try to fix this thing to get it off the trailer with the steering, and then it's time to get two cars ready for the pavement Derby, Speedrome style.